In this brief tutorial, I will show you how easy it is to start working with EASE Evac. First things first, what is it that we are trying to achieve when using the software? One of the main applications we are interested in is simulating how well a message transmitted from a distributed loudspeaker system will be understood by a large number of people within a given space. Normally, our large space that would require several loudspeakers, and typically either wall or ceiling mounted loudspeakers. For this, the first step is to enter the room geometry into EASE Evac. We can do this with the assistance of a layout map, which we can load here. This is a background picture or a drawing we can import into EASE Evac to assist us entering the room. So I'm going to open this top view. And position the room origin. I'm going to enter 0, 0 for the origin coordinates. Then I'll specify the scale by entering the distance between the start and end point of this line. Press OK, and now we have a background drawing added to our project. And all we need to do is dragging these vertices to the correct positions to define the room layout. So this is a room with a defined height. You can see here room height will be 6 meters. And here we define the room walls. So we can see on the left-hand side a table with the coordinates of the vertices. You can fine-tune these coordinates here or correct them here as you need. This is all we need to do to enter the room geometry, and then in the next step we'll define other room settings and also assign materials to these walls. So the room geometry is ready. I'll now define what is it the voltage I want to use for this network and also the room name. We'll get back to the positioning of the loudspeaker soon, but now the next step for us is to assign materials to the walls of this room. So I'm going to switch now to the surfaces tab, and you can see here a list of all the surfaces. If I click on the list, the surface is highlighted in my outline. And for the floor, I can assign a material, for instance, carpet. For the ceiling, gypsum. And if my ceiling has more than one material, I can just add more areas here and define what is the area that is occupied by that material. So in this case, I'll just add a random fiberglass board and so on. Of course, these materials define the sound absorption characteristics of each wall through the absorption coefficients. So I have here a version of the room with all materials assigned already. And if we switch back to the room tab and then click reverberation time, you can see the reverberation time calculated for this room regarding the materials you chose and also the dimensions of the room. So the RT is calculated according to Eyring. Please have a look at the literature for a good understanding of the Eyring formula and its assumptions. And alternatively, to assigning materials to the room, we could have imported a measured reverberation time in 1/3 octave values. So all you need to do is modify one of the provided reverberation time files and then import it into Evac. So in our case, I will use the statistical calculation according to Eyring and press OK. So now that we have computed the reverberation time, next we should define the noise levels for this room. This will be important for the STI calculations, as the background noise is one of the factors that affect the STI. Here you can see the 1/3 octave values for the NC45 noise criteria curve that I've imported for this example. Here is the broadband noise level. With the room ready and properly modeled, we can now move forward and design our mass notification system. We can now position our loudspeakers and later fine-tune them. If I switch to the Auto Arrange tab, I can select Automatically Arrange Sound Sources, define my tab settings, and then the overlay type that I would like to use. In this case, I will specify the distance as being 8 meters randomly. So you can see that the loudspeakers are automatically arranged in the room based on the room outline and also the room height. And if you turn on Show Mapping, you can already see the direct SPL coverage. With the SPL on, you can fine-tune your system. For instance, offset it by 3 meters until you reach the desired coverage. Of course, you can also use our statistical tools. For instance, the distribution graph. Here you can see the average level and standard deviation. And if you switch to the cumulative distribution graph, you can see that 90% of the area is covered by at least 75.6 dB. And 80% of the audience is being covered right now with 76.9 dB. You can also add a wall-mounted loudspeaker by clicking a wall and switching to the front view. You can just add speakers. If you right-click it, you can change its properties. And from the side view, you can also change the angle. There are also additional tools that can help you evaluating the coverage. For instance, the receivers and the frequency response graph. You can insert several receivers in the room and then evaluate the frequency response at those specific locations. And also turn on the relative mapping, which will highlight the area that's within average plus or minus a tolerance specified by you. In this case, 2 dB, could be plus or minus 3, plus or minus 6 dB, and so on. So at this point, you already start going through an iterative process and fine-tuning the loudspeaker positions and seeing the results until you have a coverage that meets the design criteria specified for your project. And you would also do this while checking other acoustical parameters such as the STI. I'm going to open a version of this project with the loudspeakers already in place for the purposes of this tutorial. And here, before we move on for the STI simulation results, we need to make sure to have the proper settings for our input signal. That is, speech spectrum must be selected, and also the crest factor for our input signal must be speech. This will assume a 12 dB crest factor for our input signal. Now we can switch to STI simulations. And here you can see that in this case, we have an average STI of 0.52. And 90% of our area is covered by an STI of at least 0.5. You can also switch to other acoustical parameters such as AlCons and CIS scale. And also evaluate the total SPL in the room, which includes the direct sound from the loudspeakers plus the reverberant sound field. In our case, 90% of the area is covered by an SPL of at least 86.7 dB. And we also have an average SPL of 86.9 dB. This example shows results that could already meet the design criteria for a project. If not, you could continue to fine-tune the system using different loudspeaker brands or position them differently. In our example, I'll assume now that this is the design that meets our criteria, and I could now create a report that could be shared with third parties or colleagues at work. Here you can choose which information you would like to include in the report. If you'd like to include additional mappings other than this one that you see, I will select, for instance, total SPL, broadband, and AlCons. When saving the report, you can choose between RTF file, which is an editable file. You can open with Microsoft Word and then just copy the information to your own report or adapt it as you need, or you can save it directly as a PDF file that can be shared. So here we have an example of report for this project. You can see the essential project information, which signal spectrum was selected, which crest factor for the input signal, what was the SDI standard that was regarded for the simulation, the dimensions of the room, surface area, and so on, as well as the coordinates for each vertex in the room, all the materials that were applied, the noise levels we defined, the calculated reverberation time, all the positions of the sound sources in their settings, and the results. There are, of course, some features we didn't cover here, such as multiple rooms, import and export of CAD files, section planes, objects, but you can find clear information about those in the user's guide. Feel free to download a trial version so that you can have a look at the software for yourself. And as a last remark, if you need to perform advanced acoustic calculations with more complex rooms with varying ceiling, please refer to EASE. That's our complete acoustic simulation software. If you have any questions, please get in touch.